Two Wonderbook games are augmented reality games. They are exclusive to PS3, and actually, they are so exclusive that just having a PS3 and the discs for the games isn't enough to play the games. In order to play the games, you need a PlayStation Move equipment, the PlayStation Eye and the Move controller, and not only that, but you also need the book, which is specially made for these two games. And without the book, you can't play the games. But luckily, if you lost your book, or if you found the games somewhere and bought them, but they didn't came with a book, luckily, you can print the book. And I will try to scan my book and leave a link in the description of the files in case you lost your book. But beware, that the experience is worse with a DIY made book. I mean, the best way to experience the game is with an original book, because the book feels sturdy and is very solid and nice feeling, but with printed papers the experience just isn't the same. But in case you've lost your book and can't find another one, at least you can replay your game with printed copies of the book. So I'll try to leave a link in the description with a scanned book, so that you can print yourself a book and make a DIY one. But beware that the experience might be worse. Okay, so what are the games? As I said, they are augmented reality games, which means that what the camera sees can be influenced by body movement. For example, you can brush the dust off the book or use the PlayStation Move remote, which becomes a wand to move the text around and cast spells. The games are actually pretty neat, especially if you are a Harry Potter fan. The two stories are well written in my opinion, and they touched J.K. Rowling's art of telling a story. The augmented reality isn't perfect though. You can see throughout the whole gameplay moments where if you look close at the screen, you can see the imperfections. But considering the circumstances, the games are really nicely made, and the imperfections are never bothersome unless you want to nitpick. In the first game, the Book of Spells, the game consists of you learning a huge lot of spells, and in the second one, Book of Potions, you learn a lot of potions. And I like the style of getting through each element. First, the narrator tells you what you are going to learn. Then you do some interlude stuff that differs from game to game and from spell slash potion. Then comes a part where you test the spell slash potion. After that comes story time, which as a Harry Potter fan is the best part of the games in my opinion. And then you are put to a test. The way the games play is by flipping the pages of the book, tilting them, dusting them off, flicking your wand over it. Optional, you can even shout spells to your camera that has an inbuilt microphone. The games aren't that long, they take you around 4 hours each. Normally, I will see that they are short, but considering that they are children games, I mean, even if they are incredible games for any Harry Potter fan, the target audience are still the kids. And also, considering that they are augmented reality games, 4 hours of gameplay is fantastic. And those 4 hours are filled with varied stuff to do. Okay, the second one, Book of Potions, might feel more repetitive, especially since the heating minigame gets to be repeated too much. But overall, the experience is varied. It follows the set formula, but each spell brings something you haven't seen before. Also, I streamed the gameplay of the two games, and it seems that the games look really boring. Many people commented me that. So, there are two alternatives. One, either the game is fun only if you play it yourself, but looks boring if you look at someone else play it. Or two, the games are boring for a non-Harry Potter fan, but since I'm a big HP fan, I like the games. Also, in the first one, I didn't like that you had to carefully pay attention to the narrator for the tiniest thing. And one wrong button press made him shut up and not give me any further indications. That's how I landed not knowing what to do anymore in the game. I pressed a button by accident. Then I progressed to the end of the chapter, the narrator told me to flip the book and start chapter 2, but the menu told me that it's locked. I still had things to do in chapter 1, so I restarted the game on a new game and noticed that before I haven't done some stuff because I pressed the button by mistake and I didn't knew what I had to do since the narrator was shutting up. And remember that this is a children's game. The narrator in the first game has this bug, which is very annoying if it happens to you, and it can happen. I mean, what are the chances of a child mispressing a button or pressing a button by accident on the PlayStation Move controller? Also, there are no updates for the game, which means that since the release, they never fixed the bugs. I checked in 2020 if there are any updates, and there were none. And also, between the two games, you can see the progress. The second one has better graphics, and the narrator repeats everything so that the mishaps from the first game don't happen again. The controller layout also feels better in the second game, so yeah, the first one is more varied but suffers from some bugs. The second one is more polished and with bugs fixed, but is slightly more repetitive. Anyway, if you ever get the equipment for the two games, I recommend you play them. I enjoyed them and recommend them to you and to your kids. Even if from the video you might get the impression that they are boring games, I recommend you to play them, if you get the equipment. I enjoy them. So yeah, my opinion is that they are good games.